I got a quick precept. This is the book of Thessalonians, the second chapter. And I'm going to start at verse 7. It says, "For the mystery of iniquity doth already work. Only he who now letteth will let until he be taken out of the way. And then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth, and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming. Even him whose coming is after the working of Satan, with all power and signs and lying wonders, and with all deceivableness of unrighteousness in them that perish, because they receive not the love of the truth, that they might be saved." So this so-called white man is the devil. He's coming after the working of Satan, all right? The spiritual demon Satan, which is not a character that's underground, under the earth. That's another lie they told, right? That's Roman. Rather, that goes back to actually Greek mythology, yeah, right? Which the Romans and the Greeks, in the beginning of the Roman Empire, they kind of basically blended in together because they had something called the Greco-Romans.
That's right.
Which basically, like the brother said, they're brothers, they're all Edomites, so they got the same spirit. So a lot of the Roman gods actually even go back to Greek gods.
That's
but
right.
It's because they all Esau. Mm-hmm. So this is the man that is speaking of in Second Thessalonians, the second chapter. It's actually talking about a son of perdition, all right? It's talking about a wicked that was going to be revealed. And that's the time that we live in. And
that's
the time
right.
when this was written, this was actually an epistle of Paul. What time was Paul living in? The Roman Empire. What did he say? "For the mystery of iniquity doth already work." So what is this showing you? That the mystery of iniquity is this so-called white man. He is the mystery of iniquity. That's why even in the ancient Rome, not to go super deep, but they was actually going into Babylonian customs.
Yeah.
You know, that's why Esau is, in the scriptures, he's tied in with Babylon. Going into Revelation, Babylon the Great, and even King David, like the brother said earlier, King David, in the book of Psalms 137, actually tied the knot between Esau and Babylon.
That's right.
So, you know, this thing is all one lump of sin. That's what we living in a very wicked time right now, you know, where the Most High is not being glorified on the earth. And people got to start waking up to realizing that. Like, the whole earth right now is worshiping Satan. That's just the facts.
Also,
that's in the Bible. There was going to be a time period that men was going to fall away from the faith. And it says in the scriptures, say that the land shall be barren of faith.
Yeah.
And we basically, you know...
So when Paul said that the mystery of iniquity doth already work,
right.
The reason that Paul knew that because he was a man of the Lord, he was a prophet, okay? He was a watchman on the watchtower, you know what I'm saying? Because it was a mystery, you know what I'm saying? All our people didn't know that. I mean, all things are now revealed to all people, you know what I'm saying? It was a great mystery that the people ruling over the Lord's people, the Romans, were actually the devil. The mystery of iniquity, huh? And I'm saying that's not something that everybody can receive. But we receive it, and we know, according to the Bible, that is true. We read Revelation. We read the prophecies. We know who's ruling over us in these last days. When you read Revelation chapter 2, verse 10, it says the devil shall cast some of you into prison. Who cast John the Revelator? You know, that's our brother. He was a prophet. One of the apostles of Yahushua, of the Lord. So-called black man, he was cast into prison. Who had the authority to cast people into prison back then? The Romans.
Right. So the Edomites.
And these last days, who has authority to snatch somebody up from across the earth and bring from the desert of Arabia or the desert of Iraq or Afghanistan and bring them to a damn Brooklyn Federal Court, you know what I'm saying? Or Washington, from Washington Court. The devil shall cast, you know, someone even to prison, talking about the Lord's people. But they have the authority and the power as the devil, as Satan on earth, the physical manifestation of Satan,
right,
to snatch up anybody and cast them into prison. You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
So that was the point, that we are living in the modern Roman Empire.
That's right.
And our Lord was killed in the ancient Roman Empire. So these are some of the things that the watchman is seeing in these days, but telling the people, warning the people, we're living in those same days. In 70 AD, the Romans actually destroyed our people. That was the last time our people, Judah, Benjamin, and Levi, lived in the homeland. Okay? You know, you had others in the Dark Ages, like the Knights. They set up a Christian kingdom in the Dark Ages in Jerusalem. But our people was destroyed forever, you know, in 70 AD. The Romans did that. Okay? So that's going to come again. The armies shall compass about Jerusalem again. And Jerusalem is the people, the Black Americans, the Hispanics, and Native Americans. We are Jerusalem, and those Roman armies is coming back. Right now, it's called United States military. Okay?
That's right. Why do you think the so-called white man, not to go too off topic, but why do you think when Christopher Columbus, why do you think they came over here? Because they knew that the rest of the tribe was over here. Don't, if you go into the history, you would find out that Christopher Columbus actually carried, if I'm not mistaken, he had an apocrypha with him. And he had Hebrew translators. He had about three, I believe. He had three Hebrew translators with him. When he came over here and the Taínos, you know, on the island of Hispaniola, they were speaking a form of Hebrew. And that's how he knew that the Lord's people was over here on the Western Hemisphere. Why they didn't just build up their empire over there? Why they didn't just stay in Europe and conquer that whole land there? Because they knew that the children of Israel was on this side of the hemisphere. What did they do? They came over here, destroyed the Northern Kingdom, and then what did they do? They brought the Southern Kingdom over here. That's what the prophecy fulfilled in the scriptures. Judah and, what did it say? Judah and Jerusalem?
That's right, yeah.
Or Judah and Israel shall, you know, roughly happen, and they will serve captivity together. You know, so that's what's happening right now. We in captivity under the Romans once again. You know what I'm saying? And this end, the Most High is about to really, like, if any other time he destroyed the earth, 2 Peter the 3rd chapter tells you he destroyed it by water the first time. But he's going to destroy this shit by fire this time.
That's right.
Now it really went out of hand. Now they put us in slavery. They was hanging us on trees. You know all the wickedness this man did? You think he's going to get away with that? Everybody thinks that the earth is just going to continue on forever now. Like, forget about that past. What about the past of them killing the Lord? When did the Romans ever pay for killing Yahweh Shai? Who paid for that? Why do you think in Revelation, when he actually comes back the second time, he's going to get those that pierce him? Because they never paid. Now they're going to pay. So this is the time of restitution and
that's
recompense.
Right.
You know, the time that we're living in. Even for us. This thing is scary for us. That's why we're getting the blood off our hands and we're warning the people. Because we could even be destroyed, you know? We sinned against the Heavenly Father. You know, he was brought for his people. That's why he destroyed us. But get how much more for you heathens, no? But that's a quick point that I wanted to make. I had a scripture going on the whole, you know, Ecclesiasticus, the 12th chapter and the 10th verse. Never trust thine enemy, for like as iron rusteth, so is his wickedness. So obviously the enemy of Jacob, go back to the story of Genesis, the 25th chapter. All right, there was a hatred from the womb. There was a battle going on inside of Rebekah's stomach, which was between Esau and Jacob. Esau is the progenitor of the so-called white men, the white people, the Caucasians, the Europeans, whatever you want to call them, the Spaniards, Italian, or some Italians, not all, but Italians, the Romans, the Greeks, you know, whatever name they went throughout history, that's the progenitor of those people. The progenitor of our people, the so-called Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, is Jacob. And there's been a war between those two nations ever since they was in the womb.
That's right.
So that's our enemy. That's our eternal enemy, so to say, you know? Mm-hmm. And the scripture tells you, I think it's in the book of Ezekiel, it says he had a perpetual hatred. Esau has a perpetual hatred for our people. Like I said, why do you think he came over here from the other side of the earth just to come here to destroy the Native Americans?
That's right, yeah.
If it was really about, you know, him, some people say they try to defend him, he was a hero. How is he a hero? He came over here and destroyed pretty much almost extinct a nation of people.
That's right.
That ain't no hero, man. These devils got the nerve to actually give him a day out of the year, Christopher Columbus Day, man. That's some prideful ass shit. That's showing you this man is a devil, you know? But they say, never trust thine enemy. So that's still our enemy. Just because today we living in the kingdom, we walking down the street with them, they smiling in your face, they still your enemy, man. And they gonna come down on you again. This whole thing is gonna have another repeat. History repeats itself.
That's right.
Don't read the book of Esther. Like the brother said, Jerusalem, when you saw she Jerusalem come past with armies, if I'm not mistaken, Yahweh Shai said that.
That's right.
He was one of the disciples. You know, so when we see this thing happening again, which we're seeing now, we see the martial laws getting established. The FEMA camps, they starting to build more camps and stuff like that. You see this thing happening, man. You see the false flags. They got Jake out here acting crazy, you know, on all type of drugs and shit. They ready to just kill you, nigga. That's why you be getting shot down in the street. That's why your kids, your unarmed, you know, young black males and young Hispanic and young Native American males get shot down in the street because this thing is really about to happen. This whole thing is about to unleash on us. I mean, you know, our people don't even know.
Donald Trump has that real ancient Roman spirit on him right now. They're talking about the militarism of Donald Trump and his agenda with the military. He's going to spend the most money, the biggest budget in the history of the United States of America is going to be, he's going to attempt to, you know, pass that, you know, Congress, you know, they have checks and balances, but the idea is the militarism of the Roman Empire is back, okay? when that spirit of the Romans comes back upon so-called white men, the Edomites, our people is going to see the true nature of the beast.
That's
okay?
Right.
Because that's the ancient beast, the Roman Empire. You know what I'm saying? They're not Christians. This is one of the greatest lies in history that so-called white Europeans of Greco-Roman descent, those people are the Greeks and the Romans. The Greeks and the Romans were not the Lord's people. They were not Israelites, and they were not Christians. You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
There's many things that people have to be taught again, because a lot of history has been misconstrued, confused, purposely mishandled, and taught to our people and to confuse the issue. You know what I'm saying? These people were never Christians. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
They were never the people that followed the Lord in ancient Israel. All the people throughout ancient Europe, you know, in the Dark Ages. This is why in the Renaissance, they started their campaign to destroy our people. Like the brother was saying, Christopher Columbus and them, they came out of the Renaissance, in the 1492.
Right.
And the Borgia family, that was the first family of the Renaissance, a papal family from the Vatican.
That's right.
You go into their history, those are very, very wicked people, notorious people, a notorious family of wicked men and women, the Borgia family, okay? So this is the Romans we're talking about. And the watchmen, we're on our top, we're seeing these things in history. We're looking back in history, we're looking forward in prophecy through the grace and mercy of the Lord. And we're seeing these things warning our people that these things are going to... History repeats itself, like they say. It actually comes from the Bible. There's no new thing under the sun, okay? So what we got...
She had another precept for that, too.
Yeah.
Because it says that in Ecclesiastes, it says it in 3 and 15 again, but it also says that the Most High requires that which is past. So not only, let's just read it, Ecclesiastes 3 and 15, that which hath been is now, and that which is, and that which is to be hath already been.
That's right.
And the Most High Yahweh requireth that which is past. So they're not going to, they have a tab that they got to pay, man. They've done a lot of wickedness from the time they've been in rulership. You know, even going back to the time of ancient Babylon, man, they took part in destroying our people all the way in ancient Babylon. That was thousands of years ago. Then they destroyed the Lord when he came. You know, they didn't destroy him, but, you know, they put him on a cross. They crucified him. You know, so the Most High requires that stuff. You know, as a nation, it says, smite the shepherd and the sheep shall flee. That was our leader. That's our king, man. That's why they put it on the cross. Even though they did it in mockery, but he is the king of the Jews, man. He's the king of Israel. Yahweh Shai, and they killed the king. So what do you think is going to happen to that nation as a people, you know? What do you think the Lord is going to do to them? That's how the Most High deals. He deals with nations. He doesn't deal with individual people's actions. He's a great king over the earth. He's going to deal with, you have to take responsibility for, you know, your people and your children.
Yeah, they have to pay for what they did in the transatlantic slave trade.
That's
the
right.
West Coast of Africa. They have to pay for what they did to... our people during the Jim Crow era, that's down south, you know, the separatism, the hardcore racism down south, you know what I'm saying? But what they did in the Trail of Tears with the Gadites, North American Indians, the Trail of Tears, they have to pay for what they did putting our people into reservations. The Spaniard Edomites have to pay for destroying almost all the Tainos, you know what I'm saying? They have to pay for what they did to the Aztecs, the Mayans, the Incas. Why? Because those are some of the 10 tribes of Israel. These are the Lord's people.
Yep.
So not only for Judah, Benjamin, and Levi, but all the nation of Israel has suffered under the modern Roman people.
Yep.
So-called, they call us, this is the name they give themselves, so-called white people. So we have to use those terms. We know there's nobody that's actually white, and there's nobody that's actually black.
Right.
These are just descriptive terms to describe certain hues of color, you know what I'm saying? Our people, some of our people pass for white, you know what I'm saying? But we are of an indigenous descent. Our people have been raped, robbed, and murdered, you know what I'm saying? But some of us are dark-skinned. We can have dark-skinned, near-black grandfathers and be light-skinned, you know what I'm saying? So who did that? Who's the cause of that? The damn Romans, okay? The Romans coming in the form of the Spaniards, okay? The Spaniard Edomites. They came as the British Edomites, and the French Edomites. They raped, robbed, and murdered Native Americans, okay?
Yep.
They did the same thing with slavery to our brothers, the Black Americans, the Jamaicans, so-called Jamaicans, and so-called Haitians. We are one people. We are the 12 tribes of Israel, okay? So we're warning the people out here.
That's right.
What we got, brother?
I got Psalms 55:21. It says, the words of his mouth were smoother than butter, but war was in his heart. His words were softer than oil, yet were they drawn swords. Mm-hmm. So that's talking about, obviously, that's talking about the so-called white man, because nobody else on the planet Earth is the word devil just means to deceive, deceiver. He's the one that came and signed how many treaties with the Native Americans?
You know? 450.
Right, and he broke every last one of them and more. You know, he broke treaties that he never even made. He did so much wickedness to them. You can't even count it up, man. We don't even know what he did. We just know what they said that he did. Like, when we go into the history and stuff, that one dude, De La Casas, I think his name is.
Okay, yeah.
You know, he wrote a lot of things about what they did. They was hanging the Native Americans. They was basically barbecuing them. They had, I forgot what they called it back then. There was a certain name, but it was basically a modern-day grill. Like, they made big grills.
I think it's called barbacoa. That's where barbecue comes from.
Right, right. And they put the Native Americans on them and actually burned them. And then sometimes they used to hang them and put them over the grill and burn them and hang them at the same time. So, yo, this man really has war in his heart. The reason why I'm bringing that up is just to tie it back into the scripture I just read. But I didn't finish reading it. I'm going to go back to it one more time. Ecclesiastes 12:10. Never trust thine enemy, for like as iron rusteth, so is his wickedness. Mm. So his wickedness he's rusted. You know, he hasn't shown his true colors in a while. So now, like the brother is bringing out and explaining that Donald Trump, with this whole spirit, the march spirit, which even the word march itself, it sounds like a war, like a marching band, you know, like a warrior, troops, right? They bring him back this ancient war, which is a false god anyways, but I'm going to just use it for the sake of edification, the god of war, the Roman god of war, which was Mars, which brother brought out the etymology. It goes back to March. I mean, the word March goes back to Mars, the Roman god of March.
There's no coincidence, Slotkin, that he made March 2nd or March 3rd.
It's right March now? 2nd. No,
okay, March 2nd, Donald Trump, the president, so-called President Trump, okay. he made a first time he's on the battleship making a speech, wearing an admiral's hat and an official military jacket, you know what I'm saying? Whereas these so-called veterans had issue with him wearing those specific clothing, a military jacket and an admiral's hat. So where are we in? We are in the month of March, which goes back to the god, the so-called god Mars, which is the god of war.
That's right.
It has come out the last couple of days of Donald Trump wanting to have the biggest budget, military budget in the history of the United States of America. Is it a coincidence? Nothing is a coincidence, really. This is the spirit that's on the earth right now, okay, mm-hmm. of war. And it so happens we are in the month of March. So all these things tie in with the Roman spirit, you know what I'm saying? The so-called god, Mars, was the god of war the Romans.
Right.
Okay? And we know through the Illuminati, the Freemasons at top levels, because you have Freemasons that are really nobodies, but Freemasonry at top levels, the Illuminati, the secret societies, those ruling families of Europe, in the Vatican, in the British, so-called royalty, the Rockefellers, the Rothschilds, we know that they go into the ancient cultures, the ancient gods and goddesses, and they worship those things. Ultimately, they're worshiping Satan. So they do certain rituals on ritual dates, you know what I'm saying? They know that so-called Easter goes back to Babylon. They know so-called Christmas goes back to Babylon. They know so-called Valentine's goes back to Babylon. But they still celebrate. They let their population of their people in the Western world, specifically America, carry out those rituals, and the media promotes it. And beside that, they do rituals all the time. Donald Trump was in the Temple of Jupiter, which is the Congress. You know what I'm saying? He had the fasci symbols. It was March 1st. So they know what they're doing. They're worshiping Satan through the symbolism and certain dates, numerology, and all that garbage. So our people got to come back. Because this is a warning. These people are on the path to destruction, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Which are the ancient Romans come back as the Americans.
When you go into the book of Isaiah, the 47th chapter, it tells you about how Esau, which it says virgin daughter of Babylon. Yeah. But we know Esau is the virgin daughter of Babylon, which would really be America, because actually the brothers brought this out the other day. It's the virgin daughter of Babylon, because this land has never been touched by a major
war. That's right.
It's never been touched by a nuclear missile. All right? Yeah. There's many nuclear missiles that exist. They dropped nuclear missiles on Japan, but America itself has never been it's never really had a war like that, like a real hardcore, you know, nuclear or real, like a lot of people dying, you know?
So that's right.
This is the virgin daughter of Babylon. The point is that when you read that chapter, when you read the whole chapter, it talks about how Esau is basically in his enchantments and his sorceries, and that's what they're doing. That's what the brother was just talking about. But it says what? When that sudden destruction shall come upon them, it's not going to save them. So they're going to do that until the very last end. So don't ever expect this so-called white man to come out and tell you what he's doing. He's going to be doing his witchcraft and wickedness till the end, till he gets destroyed. So if you're looking for the so-called white man to come out and tell you what we're telling you, you're not going to find it. You're going to have to look spiritually. You're going to find it spiritually. With the Most High, you know, he's going to give you the gift to see those things, the gift of vision.
That's right.
Because we see this thing clear as day. We're seeing it. So I'm going to go back to this one scripture real quick. Psalms 55 and 21. The words of his mouth were smoother than butter.
Yeah,
so that's like all the speeches. Salaki, now go ahead, break it down.
Yeah, you said it before. It was about the beast troopers.
Right. But you could also tie it in today because the speeches and stuff, they're smoother than butter. Donald Trump is coming out giving these nice speeches, sounding all eloquent. Oh, yes, make America great. But what he's really saying in code word is make Esau great, or make the so-called white man great, or make America white again.
That's right.
You know,
right.
They want to revive that ancient spirit. And it's not even really that ancient when you look at it. You could go back 500 years and they was in that spirit of destroying the Native Americans, castrating the so-called, you know, the tribe of Judah, the so-called Negroes. You know, they trying to revive that ancient spirit again, that original Edomite spirit.
Yeah.
That's what they want to revive. That's why the homosexuality is coming back out. The book of Deuteronomy 32 tells you they are the vine of Sodom. You know, so they are the Sodom is basically where you get sodomy from, like anal sex. You know, and that's basically what they into. They like doing that shit. You got Edomite men in America that's having sex with male dogs, bro. That shit is sick. These people are sick. They trying to revive that spirit back and actually, like normalize it. They trying to make it like, oh, it's okay to do it.
Yeah, they already did. Cause that's why that top film of 2016 was so-called Moonlight. You know what I'm saying? That was that right there. That's a throwback to the ancient forefathers of the Greeks and the Romans.
Yep.
So. We know that we just have to read Romans chapter 1, verse 26 and 27 to know that our forefather Paul, the apostle, so-called black man, is warning the people back then about sodomy, okay?
Right.
About the faggots, so-called faggots and lesbians, that was happening in the Roman Empire. And it's clear as day that it's happening in the modern Roman Empire, which is America, because the top film, the top entertainment, let's call it that, the top entertainment, top pastime.
That's it, won the Grammy, right?
Yeah, and it won the Oscar.
Excuse me, I keep saying
that. The Oscars.
The Oscars, a lot.
It won, you know, they actually put Jakes in that movie. You know what I'm saying? So we know this country has to be put down by judgment on high.
And it's going
to
be fired. Okay, I got this quick scripture real quick. It says, this was 2 Peter, so the brother just mentioned how Paul condemned it. Because a lot of people, you know, they only deal with the New Testament. Okay, that's cool. But even in the New Testament, the final authority of the apostles and Yahweh Shai, it still condemns homosexuality. So there's no way you letting the Most High is going to let faggots and lesbians come into the kingdom of heaven. They're going to be put to death. And this is the proof right here. 2 Peter 2 and 6. And turning the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah into ashes, condemned them with an overthrow, making them an example or ensample, which means the same thing, unto those that should live, that after should live ungodly. I'm going to read that one more time. And turning the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah into ashes, condemned them with an overthrow, making them an example unto those that after should live ungodly. So the Most High destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah with fire. That's why I said turn them into ashes. And we read in Revelation 11 and 8 that basically that city, the great city Babylon, which was going to be the last kingdom to rule before the Lord comes back, is called spiritual Sodom. So it's no wonder why did they legalize homosexuality, and they actually defending sodomites and lesbians, the so-called white men. So you know this guy has to be Esau in the spirit. You have to see that. You got to understand that. And if you once you understand that he is Esau, then you got to go deeper. Now you're gonna understand what is he about to do right now. He's about to do Psalms. I'm gonna go back to it one more time. Psalm 55 and 21. The words of his mouth were smoother than butter, but war was in his heart. So this guy, you know, starting with the elites and the presidents and the Congress, all of those dudes, they got war in their heart. They want to destroy the very citizens of the United States, even you other so-called white people. But they're going to destroy all you nations. That's why the prophecies talk about every man fleeing back to his own country. Because these nations are going to go back like, whoa, this guy is crazy. When this final revelation of this so-called white man, the devil, when he gets revealed on like on a full level, like the brother said, from on high, and he gets destroyed, it's going to put fear in everybody's heart. Because we all going to know, like, yo, this nigga was berserk. They say they shall be like madmen sparing none. You see what I'm saying? This thing is about
to really quickly, the Most High is going to turn it on. He's going to turn that fire on these... And these so-called Americans fast because we know NATO, the 10 horns of Revelation, is actually going to burn this country with fire.
Uh-huh.
And it's talking about the ICBM technology, nuclear missiles. Russia shall launch their nuclear missiles on America. And the nations, the European nations, their own brothers, their own flesh from Europe is going to destroy this country, America. So the New World Order, whatever time period the Most High allows, you know, that plan to proceed. You know, it could be a couple weeks, it could be a couple months, it could be a couple years. We don't really know the time period the Most High is going to allow these people to set up their martial law, their concentration camps, their FEMA camps, the RFID chip technology. But we know, we have confidence in Yahweh Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shah. We have faith that they're going to be put down speedily, you know what I'm saying? Speedily, they're going to be put down.
Scripture say, in 1 hour shall that great city Babylon be destroyed.
Yeah, there'll be race wars too, so it don't matter your concentration camps, your tanks, your militias, all your soldiers are going to be in the Valley of Megiddo. All your soldiers, your Marines, your Air Force, all of them, the Most High is going to take them from this country and put them into the Middle East. Because the Most High controls the nations. He controls the armies of the world. The Lord Yahweh, okay? In the name of his son, Yahweh Shah.
Right.
So there's going to be race wars here, there's going to be concentration camps, there's going to be famine, there's going to be straight chaos in the streets of America. Okay? So whatever you do, you come back with that Roman spirit, it's going to be put down.
Yep.
And we see that as watchmen. We see that once you try to come against the people of Israel and come against the Lord, the men of the Lord, the Israelite men, starting with the apostles on down, the men that teach in the camps, once you come against us, this is a wrap for this country, United States of America, for Babylon the Great, for the modern Roman Empire. So we have all confidence in that.
Yep.
So we're warning the people, you got to come out of the customs of this nation.
Yep. So then we got a couple of more scriptures in there. So we could start getting into some articles soon. Just like a few, you know. But this is the book of Amos. So like Amos 3 and 6. It says, shall a trumpet be blown in the city, and the people not be afraid? Shall there be an evil in a city, and the Lord have not done it? So this is a trumpet that's being blown, a trumpet of war, that's being blown by the men of the Lord, right? By the prophets of Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai. And it's saying, shall a trumpet be blown, and the people not be afraid? So, you know, we know a lot of you people, chiefly two-thirds, is going to watch this and just continue on and to serve your own belly. You're not going to really care. You're not going to be afraid. But guess what? When the evil that's done in the city is the Lord doing it. So don't pray back to the Most High. Don't start praying to sweet Jesus and God when this hell actually does start coming down. When they actually put in a chip to your face and trying to implant you with a microchip, don't pray to the Lord because you forsook the Lord. You forsook him when he had his men blowing the trumpet.
That's
and he
right.
was actually showing you love and mercy, trying to make you or have you come back to repent, to come back to your heritage so you could be safe. You know, from this destruction, but you didn't want that. So why would you at the end pray to the Lord? That's why a lot of them is going to say, Lord, Lord, but he's going to say, depart from me, I never knew you. You know, Yahweh Shah said that himself, that some of you is going to say, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name? You know, that started with the scoffers, you know, the men that know that they're Israelites, but it could fit down to the two-thirds as well, because you got a lot of so-called people that, so-called prophets and pastors, you know, because the word, I think it's pastor, right, means the same thing as prophet. Or preacher. Preacher means the same thing as prophet. So you got a lot of preachers in the churches and stuff, pastors and bishops. But hey, them dudes is not in the right spirit. The Lord is not dealing with them because they're not warning you of what we wanted. They're not warning you of what the scriptures, the impending, for lack of better terms, the impending doom that's going to come upon America. And speaking of doom, they just moved it, or not just, it was a couple of weeks ago, but they moved the doomsday clock, right? 30 seconds closer to midnight. And you know what happens at midnight? The destruction. The scriptures say, Yahweh Shah said, I will come as a thief in the night. That's why we got to watch, and that's why we got to warn the people, because we don't even know when he's coming. The See what I'm saying? So even us doing this is a form of us watching, even right now, because we're ready for the Lord to come back, you know?